my friend Liz Mandel. Liz is a therapist. She's a family therapist. Liz, welcome to New Jersey 101.5. Thanks for joining me.
Hi, sure. How are you?
Good, good. And Liz, I wanted to bring this subject up, that the impact of a young person's passing is so traumatic and great. And you are a therapist that deals with couples and families and people in relationships. What do you think is going through the minds of, let's just talk first about the close friends. You know, he's got close friends that now have to get up and face the school day, the future work day, and they're without their friend. What do you think is going through the mind, and what kind of input and advice would you have for these young people now that they're struggling with this?
Well, this is a situation of complicated grief. The attachment bond has been severed so abruptly that none of these people had any time to mourn, you know, prior to Evan's death. So they are really dealing with something that is, you know, an absence, an unexplained absence that is leaving a void in their hearts that they have to get up and face every day with these unanswered questions, you know. And one of the things that they're trying to do to bring closure into their lives is through this, you know, fund and the signatures to honor his death through naming the school field after him.
Right. They're going to try to name the field after him. They're talking about retiring his number. School is going to be closed tomorrow for the funeral. Liz, do you think that the national implications of a story like this, I mean, forgetting that some people are going to use this as an opportunity to talk about the safety in youth sports. I mean, that is a recurring theme that we have. But what do you think as far as someone that's grieving, especially a couple, you know, like this was an only child. Evan was an only child. What does a couple go through?
They go through, you know, signs of post-traumatic stress. You know, they will replay over and over in their minds, you know, the points at which they knew that there were, you know, signs of danger, where they didn't know what was going to happen. They were, you know, confronting absence of answers and, you know, what the doctors told them. So they're going to go through the motions of, you know, the signs of grief, which are bargaining, denial, anger, depression, and then finally acceptance.
But what about Liz, for this young man's girlfriend? You know, we've seen a lot of Facebook posts and that, you know, love of my life, we were going to get married. I mean, all these things, it's heartbreaking to look at this.
It's absolutely heartbreaking. And the best thing that she can do is express her feelings and gather the collateral emotional support that she can get from the people close to her, because when there's a loss so abrupt like this, you know, there's a void in her heart that she needs to be filled by other sources of love.
Okay. All right, Liz Mandel, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Always appreciate your perspective, your professional expertise, and your time. We'll certainly be talking soon. Thanks, Liz.